Hey guys, welcome to Protocol Dustpoint. Okay, so in this Flutter tutorial, we're gonna learn how to create a scratch card in Flutter to reward a user. Okay, so let's begin. So here I have just created a simple demo app just as an intro of this tutorial. So you can see there is a button to show a dialog box for a rewarding. Okay, so when I press on the button, so you can see a dialog appears and it has a scratch card. So let's scratch the card and check the reward. Okay, so you can see after rubbing or erasing the some part of our scratch card, the price into it is been shown to the user. Okay, so let's learn how to implement it in our Flutter app. So let's begin. Okay, so now we are in our Android Studio and I have created a Flutter project by name Flutter Scratcher in my Android Studio IDE, and I have removed all the default code given by Flutter team, that is the counter code, and added my own code, that is stateful widget, which has a center widget, column widget and a empty children's in it. Okay, so let's begin. So first of all, you must go to popspecification.yaml file, and under dependency section you need to add a package, that is scratcher. Okay, so just add it and hit this pubget button. Okay, and I have also created a assets folder over here which has a png image, that is reward, to be shown in a scratcher as I shown in my app, this image. Okay, so you just need to create this folder and add your desired reward icon over here. Okay, so add that and just give a path to that image over here like this and hit this pubget button. Okay, so after adding the library and the image, just go to main.dart page and import the package that we are going to use, that is scratcher.dart. Okay, and you are good to go to use the package. Okay, so let's begin over here. Okay, so let's begin with implementing scratcher widget. Okay, so here first of all I will just show you the various properties provided in this scratcher widget. So let's just hit control and take your cursor over here and click, and you can see the various properties that you can use in this scratcher widget. Okay, so let's use this one by one. So I will just explain you what are these widgets. Okay, so first of all, so let me add a container over here just for time's sake. Okay, so first of all, let's give a color to this scratcher. So let's say it has blue. Okay, so let me rerun the app and check it out. So let's check. So nothing changes been applied. Okay, so let me give a height to this container, width and height, width as 200 and height as 200, and let's give a color to this container, colors dot let's say red. Okay, so this is the actual card that is inside this scratcher. When the user scratch the card, this container will be shown to the user. Okay, so this is been hidden inside the scratcher widget. Okay, so let me show you. Okay, so you can see I have defined the scratcher as blue color, and inside it has a container that is of red color. So let's check it out. So I will just scratch it over here. So you saw, so this is the scratcher that you are scratching, that is blue color, and inside it we have a container widget which is of red color. Okay, so let's check the other properties of this scratcher widget. Okay, so there is a property called as breast size. Okay, so let's make the breast size as 40 pixels. Okay, so hot refresh. So let's check it out. Okay, so you can see the size of the breast is of 40 pixels. Okay, so there is one more property, that is threshold. So let's make the threshold as 50. Okay, so let me show you what is the exact meaning of this threshold. Okay, so first of all, let me print some data. Okay, and there is one more property, that is on change. So let me make use of it to show you the example of threshold. Print. Okay, so here we need to pass a value. Okay, so let's use this. Percentage hot refresh. Okay, so let's check. So side by side we will check our console. So now when I make some changes over here, so when I try to scratch it, so you can see I am getting a print of how much percent the scratch card is been scratched. Okay, so you can see 20%, and now let's make this 20% to 50% as we have said over here, 50% threshold. Okay, so let's make it 50, 49, 50. Okay, so let's check this. So you can see a threshold callback function has been run as soon as our scratch reached 50%. Okay, so the scratch. Okay, so the threshold is something that will detect whenever the exact amount of limitation to scratch the card has been reached. Okay, so hope you got the concept of threshold. So these are the main properties of scratcher widget. Okay, so instead of this container, let me add an image over here. Okay, so the image widget is from assets folder, that is reward.png. So let me hot refresh. Okay, so let's check the app. So you can see there is a scratch card, and inside it we have our image, that is the reward been shown. So the size of this scratch card is bigger because it is taking the size of the image asset. Okay, so let's give a container for this. So you can see this is the scratch card. Okay, so let me change the size of this brush as 30 pixels. Okay, so now suppose you want to control this scratcher widget, like you want to reset this scratcher or you want to reveal the reward under it by just one button press or by programmatically in background. So what you can do is you can just make use of a key property to control this scratcher widget. So let's do it now. Okay, so let's create a key for it. So over here, let's create it. Okay, so here final scratcher key is equal to global key, and which is of type scratcher state. Okay, so let's give this key to our scratcher widget over here. Okay, so now by making use of this scratcher key, you can just control this scratcher. Okay, so let me show you an example. So let me create two buttons over here. Okay, so here I have just created two buttons just for as example purpose. So one is to reset the scratcher widget and one is to reveal the price under it. So reveal. Okay, so let's hot refresh. Okay, so let's check. So you can see there are two buttons over here. So let's give functionality to this. Okay, so to give functionality to this, what we can do is we can make use of scratcher key dot current state. So there is a property that is dot reveal reset, sorry, reset, and here you need to pass a duration in milliseconds. So let's say as milliseconds as 100 milliseconds. Okay, so let's check this out. Hot refresh. Okay, so I'm just scratching the card. Okay, so you can see. And when I press on the reset button, so you can see the scratch card got resetted. Okay, so the same thing we will do for the revealing the reward one under it. So here you just need to make use of reveal. Okay, so let's use it. Hot refresh. Okay, so I will do this and I will just press on the reveal button. So you can see the scratch card got scratched automatically and the price inside it is been shown. Okay, so that's all for this video tutorial. Hope you got the concept of how to make use of a scratched widget to implement scratch card in your Flutter app. So here I have wrote an article on how to implement scratch card widget. So the link will be in the description. You can just check it out. Okay, so here I have just created a dialog box which will pop up, and inside it we have a scratch card. Okay, so the complete code is over here. So you can just check it and you can just copy paste the code from here if you want. So all full complete main.dat code is over here. You can just copy it and paste it yourself and you can try it. So here I have just created a dialog box, and inside the dialog box we have a scratcher widget. Okay, so let's use this and you can just try it out. Okay, so thanks for watching. Please do subscribe ProtoCoders Point. Thank you.